Every line of code you write is a hypothesis, and you need to have a dialogue with the toolchain to validate your hypothesis. That dialogue needs to be healthy. It's the bread and butter, it's the heartbeat of software development. My name is Hans Doctor. I'm the CEO of Gradle and the founder of Gradle Build Tool and co-founder of Develocity. When I was a kid, 14 years old, I spent a couple of summers working to get the money to buy myself a C64. I got hooked from day one and it became a very, very important part of my life. When I started, build tools were not a thing in the Java space. I was very ambitious, right? And I ran into serious limitations with Maven. I ran into serious limitations with AND. This is so crucial for our industry to have a proper automation. But then I thought, well, we can do something better. Make the impossible possible, the possible easy, and the easy elegant. So I was toying around with the idea of creating a different build system. It was just a little personal experiment. After 2 weeks, I felt like I was onto something. A couple of months in, I got a patch. I looked at the patch and it was like, oh my God, this is so fantastic. And that patch came from Adam Murdoch. He joined the project and the two of us, right, we really, for the first years, we moved the project forward and laid the foundation to what it is today. That's how a Gradle Build Tool has started.
There was no microservice, but now the automation is far more ambitious and achieves a lot more. So these are things that Gradle has had to support and make better.
There were amazing milestones on the way. Hibernate started to migrate their build towards the Gradle Build Tool. Right? It was the first, at this time, Hibernate was one of the most important open source projects in the world. And then later, the Spring Framework migrated the Spring Core build to Gradle Build Tool. It was also a huge milestone for us, even gives us a possibility to create a living around it so that we can further invest into the Gradle Build Tool. So our goal was to create critical mass, to create a great community around it, right? To see a lot of adoption and people enjoying what we're building. The idea of Develocity took shape in some form, right, very early on between Adam and myself. How can you manage your toolchain without observability? It's impossible. You need to have acceleration technologies as your code bases are growing, right? And you need to support with failure troubleshooting. It's absolutely essential. When we got the possibility, the resources to assemble a fantastic team, and that team developed then soon its own vision that went way beyond, right, what we initially thought a Develocity could be. It was Etienne Studer and Luke Daly, right, who are the two other co-founders of Develocity, and with a great team, we built something that I think is very relevant for the industry, went way beyond Gradle Build Tool.
Our build and our project is always evolving. We're adding new functionality, new modules, things are changing, adding new tests. Getting it fast once doesn't mean it's fast forever. So keeping on top of things and understanding is key.
We started selling Develocity middle of 2017. We launched it at the Gradle Summit, which was our flagship conference at that point in time. That's when it was exposed to the world.
Gradle Enterprise is now Develocity.
Pretty quickly after release, Develocity was clear for us that there's such an opportunity, right, to provide a unified platform regardless of the build system for Develocity. And the first build system after Gradle Build Tool that we embraced was Maven, right, and it's now as important part of our user base than is Gradle Build Tool, SBT. Now we have NPM and Python support, and we're going to continue with that. Of course, one of the most important development has been the rise of Gen AI. First AI product that we created with predictive test selection, where we not just offer data for exploration, but where we use the data, right, to provide pretty amazing new capability, shortening the compute resources that you need for feedback cycle and almost give you the same quality of feedback. We're super excited about doing much more in this area. End of the day, it's about enabling software delivery excellence.